Hi all. Everything in my video is pulled from the public domain and I am using them under the Fair Use Fair Dealings guidelines. Everything I say is my own opinion. You should look into this information for yourselves, but I'm pretty sure I'm right. Well, it's happened. It's come out that Prince Charles is in a, quote, state of despair after the interview from Oprah. Harry apparently emailed his dad to justify why they had done the interview. Harry said he felt let down by his father, and apparently that was very hard for Charles to hear. Apparently, it's just now that Charles has started to look like a popular king, and this just cut at his reputation. And it's hard to know, the article says, if Harry knows how much damage he did. But personally, I think he knew what the damage was going to be. I think he just is so selfish, he just didn't care. I also had told you guys before that I felt that the palace at some point was going to have to respond to this. And apparently they're going to respond, but they're going to take their time and choose their words very carefully. Kate and Camilla were out and about today, and you could just see just the absolute hurt on their faces. I mean, Kate was the sister that Harry never had. They had such a close relationship, and now it's just gone. You know, part of what really upset me as well is he basically took a swipe at his grandmother. After all of his talk about how much he respects her, he relayed a story. Okay, here it is. Tell me what you think.
That announcement that we put out on the 8th of January in 2020, the contents of that was put into a letter to the institution, to my father, which was then shared at the end of December while we were in Canada. And to then get back on the 6th, after my grandmother had said, the moment you land, come up to... come up to Sandringham, we'd love to have a chat, come for tea, and why don't you stay for dinner, because it's going to be a long drive and you're going to be exhausted.
We shouldn't have stayed the night.
Wonderful, I'd love that.
Yeah.
The moment we landed in the UK, I got a message from my private secretary, Fiona, at the time.
Private secretary is sort of like a CEO role in the institution.
Cutting and pasting a message from the Queen's private secretary, basically saying, please pass on to the Duke and Duchess of Sussex that he cannot come to Norfolk. The Queen is busy. She's busy all week.
After she just invited you?
Yeah.
She just invited me. The Queen's busy. She's busy all week. Do not come up here. Okay. So I rang her from Frogmore that night and said, I was thinking about coming anyway, but I hear you're now busy. And she said, yes, there's something in my diary that I didn't know that I had. And I said, well, what about the rest of the week? She goes, well, that's busy now as well. Okay. I didn't want to push because I kind of knew what was going on. And then later that night...
But doesn't the Queen get to do... I mean, doesn't the Queen get to do what the Queen wants to do?
No, when you're head of the firm, there is people around you that give you advice.
Okay.
And what has also made me really sad is some of that advice has been really bad.
Now, a lot of people have been asking how people in the United States feel about this whole thing. Megyn Kelly went on Good Morning Britain and she said it best. So here's a couple of clips that'll give you an idea of how we feel.
And then while she's spinning this tale about how tough she had it in the castle, how lonely she was in the castle, she's painting herself in sort of these adorations like, it was incredibly courageous of me to come forward about my depression. And I just love saving things. And it was just peppered with these compliments of herself while she was making these complaints that will be totally unrelatable to 99% of the people out there.
And then Megyn Kelly said this.
His biggest complaint and her biggest complaint was we were worried about the security. We were worried about the security of our son. Why would they take it away? Why wouldn't they make him a prince? By the way, I care nothing about titles at all. But why wasn't my son a damn prince? Okay, so we're worried about security. And then Harry's saying, all I had was my mother's inheritance. So I looked that up. It's about $15, $16 million. So you're telling the American public, the British public right now, we're supposed to feel sorry for you because you couldn't find a way to pay for your own security when you haven't had to pay for a dime of your own life so far. The British taxpayers have paid for everything.
Exactly.
The woman was on a roll. She was voicing exactly what I was thinking. Then this came out.
Yeah, I wouldn't presume to speak for the palace, right, and how the rules are. But I think as a grown adult, you know what the rules are. And when you are a multimillionaire with all that dough in your pocket, you've never had to pay for anything your entire life, you can shell out a few dollars to protect your child.
The woman was hot and on a roll, and she continued.
Nowhere in there did I hear any acknowledgement of the enormous privilege they have, right? Some perspective saying, look, it wasn't a great experience. We chose to leave. That wasn't the way we wanted to live our lives. But we understand there's so much suffering in the world. We've seen it firsthand this past year in both of our countries. And we're good. We're grateful for the blessings we have. We're not here to complain.
And she ended with this.
And then she compared herself to the Little Mermaid. The Little Mermaid who married a prince and lost her voice. It's like, so it wasn't predictable at all to you that when you moved into the palace, someone else was going to control the press. My 6-year-old daughter knew that.
Now, while all the fallout is happening in the UK and Charles is upset and Kate and Camilla are upset and everybody's quite frankly in shock over what these two have done, they've decided now would be a good time to release another pregnancy photo. And once again, they've hidden Archie's face. And by the way, she finally had something to say about Thomas. Listen to this.
Did it feel like betrayal when you found out your father was working with the tabloids?
If we're going to use the word betrayal, it's because when I asked him, when we were told by the comms team this is a story that was going to be coming out, we called my dad and I asked him, and he said, "No, absolutely not." Mm. And I said, "You know, the institution has never intervened for anything for us, but they can try to go in and kill this story. But if they do this once, we're not going to be able to use that same leverage to protect our own kids one day."
He said, "No, absolutely not." He hadn't been talking to them?
Yeah.
Yeah. So he basically lied to you.
Well, and so when I said, "We won't be able to protect our own kids one day," mm-hmm. and I said, "So I just need you to tell me. And if you tell me the truth, we can help." And he wasn't able to do that. Mm. And that for me has really resonated, especially now as a mother.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Not being willing to protect you.
And also me saying just full stop, if we use this to protect you, we won't be able to protect our own children one day.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I'm talking about your grandchildren. So I look at Archie, I think about this child and I go, I genuinely can't imagine doing anything to intentionally cause pain to my child. I can't imagine it. So it's hard for me to reconcile that.
So,
everyone has accountability. Look, they've hunted my mom down.
Right. And she didn't speak to the tabloids.
You've never heard her say a word. She's remained in silent dignity for 4 years.
So what I got from that is Meghan threw her father away, the man who has helped her whole life because of a lie. Maybe he wouldn't admit it because he was embarrassed, but eventually you make up. But no, she's just cut him out of her life. You know, I do find it interesting that she did the whole victim narrative like Diana did. I was suicidal like Diana. I got no help from the palace like Diana. I had to find my own way like Diana. Nobody helped me like Diana. But please keep in mind that when Harry needed some mental health, he went to counseling for 7 years, but they're claiming they couldn't do anything to help Meghan. So I don't believe that. And I'm going to make one more statement. Had the Queen agreed to their Megxit demands, had they been allowed to keep Frogmore free of charge, had they been allowed to keep their security and Meghan could still buy her clothes, had everything been done but they didn't have the responsibilities except every now and then, and they could still make money on the side, I guarantee you they would still be in the UK and there would be no claims of racism or anything else. This is happening because the Queen said the one word to them that I don't think either one of them has ever heard in their lives, and that's no. Now, remember, Meghan said she didn't care about grandeur, she didn't care about titles, but she did say that one of her issues was that her son was not made a prince, that it was his birthright. But George V, the Queen's grandfather, who stipulates that as a great-grandchild of the monarch and child of the second son of the heir to the throne, he has a right to Prince Harry's subsidiary title, which would make him Lord Archie, Earl of Dumbarton. It doesn't make him a prince. Now, he will become a prince once Charles becomes king. But hopefully by then, hopefully before that happens, the queen will remove him from the line of succession. And now we're going to end this video with another Finn update. I keep trying to walk him on the leash and the poor dog is broken. He just keeps stopping, falling over, rolling around, sitting down out of the blue, and I can't make it one time around the freaking neighborhood. So here's two short videos to show you what I'm up against. Finn, how come you don't want to walk? How come you keep laying down every few steps? What's going on with you? Hey, Finn. Finn. Well, I'm guessing we need some leash training because you've only gone from that spot to here. He keeps laying down and sitting down every few steps. I'm not getting anywhere here. So, what do you guys think about the fact that she's essentially throwing her dad away over one lie that he told? What do you think about how upset Charles is and the rest of the family? What do you think about the things that Megyn Kelly said? And even worse, what do you think about the fact that after he crapped all over his family, the two of them released another lovely family pregnancy photo? It's just in such poor taste. Make sure to leave your comments below. Don't forget you can email me. Don't forget you can follow me on Twitter. And don't forget about that coffee fund. And as always, have a great day.